Hello everyone, Ian Maddox, HMFP, connecting with you here on our Financial Planning Simplified video series. About to embark on a four-part series, in fact, specifically on Roth IRAs. So, what are the four parts? Today we're going to talk a little bit about definitions. What is a Roth IRA? How does it compare and contrast to a traditional IRA? Next week, we're going to talk a little bit about Roth conversions and backdoor Roth contributions. Basically, how are some more creative ways we can get money inside of a Roth IRA? We'll follow that up on part three with how Roth savings accounts or Roth accounts can be used for college expenses. And then we'll wrap the whole thing up. Part four will be using Roth for legacy, how a Roth IRA can allow monies to go to the next generation for a long period of time. So let's dig in. First of all, what is a Roth IRA? Sometimes we cover subjects that some of you are familiar with and others are not. So let's do a little bit of compare and contrast. First of all, what is an IRA? An IRA stands for Individual Retirement Account. You've had traditional IRAs for quite some time. What is unique about a traditional IRA? First of all, monies are tax advantaged when they're inside of an IRA. Not unlike a qualified plan or a work-related retirement plan like a 401k or a 403b. Often but not always, monies can come out of a retirement plan like that into an IRA. You can also contribute money into an IRA. When you contribute money into an IRA, it could be potentially, depending on your tax situation, tax deductible. Once the monies are in the IRA, they continue to grow on a tax-deferred basis, so you don't pay any taxation along the way. So, obviously, the IRS at some point is going to put their hands up and say, hey, over here, I need my taxes. That's correct. And you pay income tax when you take money out of the traditional IRA. Okay? Now, enter the Roth IRA. Some nuance here. Some similarities, but some differences. The Roth IRA, on the contribution side, in other words, when money goes into it, it's after tax. All right? So you don't get a tax deduction for putting the money in because you've already paid tax. It's after tax monies that go in. However, here's how it's similar. As the monies are in the account, it grows on a tax deferred basis. And potentially, if you follow certain rules, you can take the money out completely tax free. Okay? What are a couple of the rules? One, the account has to be open for at least 5 years, and you have to be 59 and a half years of age to be able to touch both what you put in, which we call the basis, and the growth over however long the account's been open. If you follow those two checkboxes, those rules, you can take distributions out of that Roth IRA completely tax-free, which is pretty awesome. In 2019, give you a little bit more background information, the limits of what can go into a Roth is $6,000 if you're 49 years of age or younger. If you're 50 or over, you can do an additional catch-up contribution of $1,000, which gets you to a sum of $7,000. So if you're a married couple over 50, you could potentially be putting $14,000 a year into Roth IRAs. Now, there's a couple of other caveats to who and when you can access a Roth IRA. If you, let's for simple purposes today, let's say you're a single filer. If you make over $135,000 a year, you're not going to be able to access the Roth IRA. If you're a married couple, it's about $199,000 on the top end. That's going to wipe you out from being able to access a Roth IRA. Unless, of course, you come back and check out the part two of this series when I give you some creative solutions to getting around that rule. So until next week, Ian Maddox, HMFP. Talk to you soon.